Alright, and we will be back with the final shortly, but before that, we'll be going through today's usage statistics.
Yep.
Somewhat interesting run, I believe. Especially what is at number one for today's challenge.
And it's not Groudon. As we can see here, it's actually Kyogre.
Groudon falling all the way to number four.
Yeah.
Big six, really. As we see a nice lineup of big six there for us. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. But not number one. Number one is Kyogre for now.
I think I think quite a number of people are choosing to build teams that are anti big six or dual primals.
As we do see the reason why, as we look as right under the big six, we do see Ferroton. One of the better ones for checking the big six.
Yeah. And we also see that Emolga, because you know, Emil is very proud of his Emolga. And getting it on the usage statistic screen.
Right, so interesting options all around, and we do see two Bronzongs in fact. So players opting to players taking inspiration from Emil's PC winning team from the last PC.
And probably Aaron Zeng's very famous Bronzong.
The Poco Alex team, the Alex Gomez team that Aaron Zeng has been running on the rank.
And a lot of people having very good success rate with that team.
Yes, so we do see why Big Six is falling a bit out of favor with players doing things like running the Bronzong, running the Ferroton.
Yeah, just to counter Big Six.
But a clear winners for both the both the restricted and the mega. Kangaskhan far and away the number one mega here.
Yeah, but Smeargle still at the top of the usage statistic at number three position. A lot of people still running Smeargle for its, you know, for its psychological factor. When it's out on the field, people think that it's probably going to go for the Dark Void.
Yes, and really, even without Dark Void, Smeargle just has so much utility. With Follow Me. And now with the new sets running around with Crafty Shield,
I think the usage of Smeargle, you know, if you just send it out on the field, a lot of people are really going to be intimidated by it. And that if you're not prepared for it, you know, you can really play a lot of mind games, you know, with what is Smeargle running, you know, what kind of sets he's going to use.
So definitely we see Tailwind being the preferred method of speed control here.
Yeah.
Talonflame with 13, Crobat with 6. And even Salamence there, some Salamence are even running Tailwind as well.
Yeah.
I believe the team that we're talking about, the Alex Gomez team that Aaron Tung has been playing, his Salamence does carry Tailwind.
Yeah, indeed. It's a trick win team in fact.
So and but I think the reverse is not true as we see Trade Room really a bit of a niche pick in this tournament at least.
Yeah.
Cresselia down at 4, Bronzong at 2, and well Dialga at 1.
Yeah.
So Trade Room not really being the go-to option today.
Yeah.
With Tailwind clearly in the ascendancy.
Especially with most people using Talonflame as their Tailwind setter, because it more or less guarantees a Tailwind to be up with that Gale Winds.
We see two Giratina origin form as well. One of them actually making it to the top card.
Ah.
Though, as you would expect from a Giratina origin form, it got destroyed in top 8. Isn't that right, Justin?
Yeah.
Alright, so I believe the players are ready and we'll be moving on to the final, which will be played between Wilson Foong and Harrold Khoo. Both players we've already seen in the top 8 and top 4 matches.
Yeah.
So the teams will be no surprise to anyone who has watched the previous games.
And this is Wilson's second time at the finals match with his dual primals team. Really, you know, itself pulling a lot of weight for him, winning him a lot of matches. Yeah, even though he came in at the 8th seed, and now he has climbed his way all the way up to the finals here. Can see that his team is really working out very well for him.
Alright, so again, Harrold will be running Kangaskhan, Smeargle, Kyogre, Talonflame, Ferroton, and Rayquaza.
And Wilson will be running his dual primer team, Groudon, Kangaskhan, Salamence, Amoongus, Kyogre, and Togekiss.
So both players having dual mega options here.
Yeah, but Harrold has the speed control advantage with his Talonflame and his Tailwind.
Harrold, of course, even if he chooses to mega bring both of his megas, actually has the option because Rayquaza is not totally useless as a non-mega Pokemon.
Yep.
Whereas Wilson really only can bring one of his megas.
Yeah. And Wilson really has to watch out for that Talonflame, and especially if he chooses to bring Amoongus.
So both Kangaskhan will hit the field, and we do see Togekiss facing off against Smeargle. I believe we did note that Wilson is running the max speed Kangaskhan, and it looks like Harrold has chosen to do the same as well. So definitely a Kangaskhan speed type to look out for in turn one. Again, is either of them going to chance the inner focus play?
Yeah, will we see any inner focus shenanigans in this round?
If Wilson wants to go for the fake out, I think the obvious target out for the fake out is the Smeargle rather than the Kangaskhan.
And I think quite obviously the Smeargle will probably go for the spiky shield. Or maybe Harrold will want to go for the more risky play and go for Dark Void and assume that Wilson is predicting that he'll go for the spiky shield.
It's very difficult for Wilson to just ignore the Smeargle because of how dangerous Dark Void is.
Though if it hits, of course, if it hits.
Though you will suspect that Togekiss is probably holding the Lumberry.
Yeah.
And probably wants to go for a Thunder Wave on the Kangaskhan.
I think Thunder Wave would be the play here.
Right, we do see the Mega come out from Wilson's side of the field. Again, we do believe that both of these Kangaskhans are jolly max speed. So it's probably an issue of a speed tie here. Oh, actually no, we do see Fake Out come out from Wilson's Kangaskhan onto the Smeargle. So Harrold going for the inner focus play, not getting the results he would have liked. As Fake Out will probably go onto the Togekiss. Onto the Kangaskhan. So,
not too sure whether that's the good play or
actually,
the side.
If he considering he went for the Fake Out onto the Kangaskhan, then actually that makes no sense at all.
Yeah, actually he should have just faked out the Togekiss. Now his Kangaskhan is paralyzed.
All he did that turn was do less damage with Fake Out.
Yeah.
So a very dubious play. Perhaps I would suspect a misclick there.
Yeah.
Either he forgot to Mega Evolve his Kangaskhan or targeted the wrong Pokemon with Fake Out.
Indeed. So now Kangaskhan on Harold's side is probably the only move that can so-called outspeed is only Sucker Punch. Yeah.
And which will go into a potential Follow Me from Togekiss.
Yes.
But Smeargle goes for the Follow Me, hoping to sacrifice itself to at least go down and do something in the process.
Yeah.
As Loki goes into Smeargle, into one hit Smeargle. Will be enough. Smeargle will go down.
So we'll have a go.
No Sucker Punch coming out.
Yeah.
And no Follow Me either. Oh, are we going to see the Paraflinch come out from Wilson? Yes, we do see Ash come out, it connects. And Kangaskhan now has a very small chance to move. But he does get the attack off through the paralysis and the 60% flinch. But Double Edge not doing much at all.
Yeah.
And no Citrus Berry, so I think it's pretty safe to conclude that Wilson is carrying the Lumberry on his Togekiss.
Indeed. But with that Air Slash paralysis play, Harold's Kangaskhan more or less.
Which is why it's surprising he actually didn't go for a Sucker Punch there. His thoughts of him moving through Air Slash were actually quite low, but he went for it and he got it.
Yeah.
Alright, so Harrold going for his Kyogre and Wilson, who you would think has the Groudon at the back to switch in if he needs it.
He can either switch in to his Groudon or, you know, target that Kyogre with
He has to watch out for switching on Groudon because another play Harrold can make is to switch out Kangaskhan into Rayquaza and go for a Water Spout.
Yeah. That would be the somewhat obvious play as well, especially Harrold is using a Veogre variant type of team.
Right, so Kangaskhan, I think Wilson definitely going to be targeting the Kyogre with his Kangaskhan.
Yeah.
As Harrold does choose not to play around with Paraflinch and goes for Sucker Punch into Wilson's Kangaskhan. As Wilson's Kangaskhan will go for his own Double Edge into the Kyogre. As we saw previously, it's probably not going to be enough, though if Air Slash target comes out as well, the Kyogre will be going down.
And what will
Origin Pulse comes out and it does hit both of Wilson's Pokemon.
Will it be enough to take down the Togekiss?
Togekiss down to below half in the rain is going to
go down.
And Wilson is down to his last two Pokemon, though you would assume that one of them is the Groudon.
Yeah.
Maybe even dual mech. Actually, if it's dual primals, the weather could change either way, since we do know that they speed tie. As we do see the Groudon come out, so the weather will at least in one way be sun. We do see both primals coming out. Which weather will he get?
Yes.
He gets the rain.
Yeah, with Groudon turning primal first, the weather will go to sun and then back to rain.
At this point, Harrold is definitely switching something into the Rayquaza here. But the problem with that is that both of his Pokemon, I believe, are in low enough health that Ice Beam into either slot could actually be a safe play.
But we'll see.
I suppose neither of these Pokemon are in range of an Ice Beam KO. No, Kyogre definitely is. So the only switch you can make here is the Kangaskhan into Rayquaza.
Yeah, and I believe.
No switches, so.
Oh, okay.
Kyogre will choose to protect and let Kangaskhan sack itself and save. As he goes for a Sucker Punch
into Kyogre. Kyogre because, you know, Water Spout is. That is a critical.
That's the critical hit.
Yeah. But Water Spout is probably going to come out here.
Precipice Blades will KO the Kangaskhan if he connects, which it does.
Yeah.
And Harrold will be brought down to what you assume is his last Pokemon, the Rayquaza.
If I remember correctly, I think Wilson's Groudon is a max speed one, and his
Kyogre
is a modest one.
Ah, yeah. I see. Which is why the weather actually wasn't speed high there as well.
Yeah.
The Rayquaza does come out, so the weather will be neutral for this time at least. Though, if Groudon has Rock Slide, this could go a long way.
Yep. But I think it's more or less game for Wilson.
Rayquaza here has the option to Dragon Ascend into the Kyogre, which should take it out.
Yeah, actually true. Oh, but I know what Wilson carries on that Groudon.
Oh yes, I know what he carries too.
Yes, yes, yes. Will he use it? I think he would. Yeah, but you know, him using it in this first match would probably give Harrold a lot of information.
Though into again, even in he's gonna have Delta Stream, however.
Yeah, and yeah, he will probably take it very comfortably.
There's no Protects coming from either side. Dragon Sand should be into Wilson's Kyogre. No Mega from the Rayquaza.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be enough. Yes, the Life Orb, normal Rayquaza, is gonna do enough to take out the Kyogre, and it's Groudon against the wall. If he does not KO Kyogre this turn, he is in for a world of hurt. So Groudon will go for Hidden Power.
Hidden Power, yes. And it will take out the... Will it take it out?
Yeah, he also takes out the normal Rayquaza since there's no Delta Stream, but...
Yeah.
Harrold is banking on the Origin Pulse, which does connect.
Does
brings
connect,
down the Groudon and will bring us to...
Very, very, very close match here. But Wilson revealing that Hidden Power. I think Harrold is very critical information for Harrold to leverage.
Should Wilson have gone for the Kyogre that turn?
Yeah, yeah.
Knowing as he did that, he could only KO one that turn. And Kyogre was always going to get KO on his Groudon.
Yeah, indeed.
Because, Rayquaza, unless Rayquaza carried Waterfall, Rayquaza was not going to KO his Groudon back. And that will allow him to get the HPI's KO the next turn, after Kyogre was gone.
Ah.
So I think a misplay from Wilson there at the end game, or perhaps he predicted that his Kyogre wouldn't get KO'd by the Dragon Ascent.
Mm-hmm. But it didn't really matter because,
I think Wilson had game there as he predicted, but he targeted the wrong Pokemon.
Yeah. So now we'll be going into game two.
Again, not that many changes to be made because there was a very close set for both players, and both players really could have won the game.
Mm. But we'll have a want to mix things up a bit and lead with his Smeargle.
He did leave his Smeargle last game, which didn't really pay off because he got faked out. Alright, so Smeargle Talonflame comes out for Harrold this time. So Smeargle protected from the fake out by Talonflame. As we do see Kangaskhan Dogekiss come out from Wilson's side of the field. A very solid lead here from Wilson.
Yeah. Kangaskhan probably going to go... I think he knows that... it's very obvious that the Quick Guard and... Quick Guard and Spiky Shield play will come out on Harrold's side.
Quick Guard and Dark Void, really.
Yeah, Quick Guard and Dark Void,
If he predicts the fake out. But if he doesn't predict the fake out, then there will be a Spiky Shield tailwind. Okay, Smeargle the speed advantage going into the next turn.
So it really depends on what Smeargle is going to do in this turn.
Yeah, so Wilson is going to have to call what Smeargle does this turn. If he makes a mistake, he could be behind from turn one. And because Wilson's Dark Hits carries Thunder Wave and not Tailwind, he does not have the option of matching the Tailwind.
Yeah.
Kangaskhan goes Mega, is he going to go for the fake out?
Yeah.
Because Smeargle goes for the Spiky Shield, I think we are seeing a Tailwind come out here. Kangaskhan goes, Talonflame goes for the Tailwind as expected. So Smeargle will be going first and be throwing down Voice next turn. As Kangaskhan goes for the low kick into the Smeargle.
Not the best play from Wilson. Because
Wilson, I think, calling the Quick Guard there and getting punished for it.
Wilson choosing to Thunder Wave the Talonflame here.
In a way, like, there's not many options. There's not much else Dogekiss could have done.
Yeah, true.
Because if Smeargle had not protected, then he would have died anyway.
But it sort of really didn't matter because
Talonflame... he doesn't have Tailwind.
Yeah.
That's the problem with his Dogekiss set.
Oh,
Talonflame is fully paralyzed. So Smeargle will, Dark Void will go off.
Wait.
It will hit at least one of Wilson's Pokemon.
See the animation going into both, but doesn't...
It lands on a Kangaskhan, so the most important target is incapacitated. And it lands on the Dogekiss. Are we going to see the Lumberry?
Ah.
And yes, we do see Lumberry from the Toga case.
Yeah.
And I think we are going to see an Air Slash or even a Thunder Wave onto the Smeargle. As Kangaskhan takes his first turn of sleep, as Thunder Wave will go onto the Smeargle. And even with the Tailwind, Togekiss will be able to move first next turn. And of course, if Wilson gets a one turn wake up, this game could change really quickly.
Yep. Wilson probably going to go for the Air Slash Parahex
Shenanigans. And then we see also, in a way, we do see the weaknesses of Smeargle Talonflame lead. You do not have a lot of offense on the field.
Yeah. But Wilson is really praying for Hex to be on his side right now. For his Kangaskhan to wake up.
Smeargle does go follow me. I think we're going to see a Brayford go off next turn. As Talonflame is fully pressed once again, so that's part one of the Hex he needs.
Yeah.
Kangaskhan does not wake up after turn, one turn, but Air Slash will go into the Smeargle and will break its focus sash.
Yes.
As Smeargle Moody Boost will go off and it gets plus two speed, but with the paralysis.
Yeah, it doesn't really.
Actually, with plus two from Moody and plus two from Tailwind, I think it is faster than. It's faster than Togekiss right now. Oh, it's actually at plus four. But he does not choose to abuse his speed.
Yeah.
He goes for Follow Me once again, hoping to protect his Talonflame, who does not want to move.
Maybe Harrold doesn't realize that his Smeargle might actually be faster than Wilson.
Both of Wilson's Pokemon.
Yeah.
And it will go down, unable to fully utilize its speed boost.
Yeah.
As Kangaskhan takes his third turn of sleep. And will be guaranteed to wake up next turn. Just in time for Tailwind to expire.
Yeah, so Tailwind really not doing anything. You know,
so again, he has the option to protect and Tailwind again. Yeah. Since Tailwind ran out just in time.
I think
if he does not choose Quick Guard, then Kyogre becomes a sitting duck for the Sucker Punch.
Yeah. I think the play now for Harrold would be to protect his Kyogre and go for the Tailwind.
And hope Tailwind goes off.
Yeah, hope Tailwind goes off. You know, especially with like the two turns of paralysis, can see that Wilson's amazing hexy luck coming into play right now.
But I suppose Harrold just happens to have a very pacifist Talonflame.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to attack, but will happily use whatever support moves he carries.
Yeah.
Of course, with Kyogre on the field, Wilson does have the option to send in his Groudon. But to match that, there's also the option of Harrold bringing in his Rayquaza to negate the Sun.
So we'll see whether Harrold will call Wilson's potential switch in here. Talonflame.
No. As we do see the Protect Tailwind play going for Harrold, will he get the Tailwind?
Will he get the Tailwind?
Yes, Talonflame does choose to use his support moves.
Yes.
So maybe it's just the attacks he chooses not to use. As Kangaskhan, I think, going for the Sucker Punch here. Oh, he goes for the Double Edge and will finish off
Talonflame.
Not entirely sure. Does he really want to bring Rayquaza in right now with Tailwind just beginning? As Thunder Wave will go into the Protect and Rayquaza will come in. But here the interesting thing here is that now that Rayquaza is on the field, Kyogre will no longer get the boost from his water attacks.
Yeah.
So Togekiss is not going to go down, even to a full foul water spout. Though Life Orb Extreme Speed, is it going to be enough to take out Kangaskhan? I actually don't think so.
Either way, Harrold not looking in.
Follow Me comes out, no extreme speed from Rayquaza, since Follow Me does come out first. As Rayquaza goes for Dragon Sand into Togekiss, but we did see Togekiss take, I believe, a Double Edge quite comfortably previously.
Yep.
So this Dragon Sand should not be a problem, and it does survive, even with the critical hit.
Even with a critical hit, yeah.
Though now Kyogre will get the Water Spout off, and will finish off both the Kangaskhan and the Togekiss. So Wilson down to his last two, one of which is the Groudon.
Yeah.
And unfortunately for the Groudon, Rayquaza is on the field, denying the Sun.
Uh-huh. So what will be his next Pokemon besides Groudon?
Groudon does come out, and I think it is the
Amoongus maybe?
It is the Kyogre.
It's the Kyogre, yeah.
So he will get the rain once again, since, as he pointed out, his Kyogre is slower than his Groudon.
Yep.
But again, the weather does not matter because Rayquaza is on the field.
And Harrold still has the
Tailwind advantage.
So we'll see that the rain comes out in play.
So again, not going to do anything with Rayquaza on the field.
Yep.
And not able to Mega Evolve. Actually, he can Mega Evolve. He just has not chosen to Mega Evolve so far.
Yeah. Probably Harrold trying to make use of the rain to deal as much damage as possible with his Water Spout.
No. As long as Rayquaza is in non-mega form, the effects of weather is negated.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Though now that he's seen HP Ice, and now that he, because he knows that Kagura probably carries Ice Beam, now would be the time to Mega Evolve.
Yeah. Because anyway, the weather would negate his water spout.
Yes.
So yeah, might as well just go for the Mega Evolution and try to tank that hidden power ice.
If Wilson is carrying a fast Kagura, he's not going to be able to survive a Life Orb Dragon Ascent.
Ah, and we can see that Harrold does go for the Mega Evolution.
Delta Stream will kick in, yep. So it will be the final weather for this battle. As Groudon chooses to protect, are we going to see a double protect come out to stall out the turn of Tailwind?
Oh, I think Wilson is going to go
Dragon Ascent does go into Kyogre, so Wilson predicting wrongly. And Dragon Ascent is probably going to be able to take out his Kyogre with the Life Orb boost from Mega Rayquaza. Hey, Kyogre actually hangs on!
But I think it's a max HP one. Or is this just a low roll?
Could be a low roll. I would think it is a low roll since we did see the HP from Kyogre earlier. Though it's not going to matter because Kyogre is going to move first under Tailwind,
yeah.
Finish off the Kyogre and pin the Groudon down under Tailwind.
Yeah, Groudon is not going to deal...
Groudon has no way to 1-hit KO Kyogre.
Yeah,
and Kyogre has many ways to 1-hit KO Groudon.
Yeah.
Rayquaza is just there to deny the sun. That's all that he really needs to do in this game. And Wilson accepting his fate will eat the Dragon Ascent, which will not KO, but a subsequent attack from the Kyogre will finish it off.
Oh, that's a critical hit.
Just to add insult to injury, but again, it didn't matter if Kyogre going to move first under Tailwind to finish off the Groudon.
Ah.
So, definitely game 1 went down to the wire, and Wilson really could have won game 1, but game 2, very different story.
I think Harrold really banking on the information that he gained from game 1. And you know, with...
choosing not to sucker punch the Kyogre that turn.
And he got a bit of lucky crits here and there, but I don't think it mattered in the end. Because he really played game 2 to...
Alright, so that brings our Premier Challenge to a conclusion. Congratulations to Harrold, who has won his first Premier Challenge.
Yeah.
Wilson, not quite getting the text as you so elegantly put it, he needed.
But still, 20 points is quite a significant amount of CP, so I think Wilson would be happy for his achievement in this Premier Challenge. Yeah.
So again, it's really what could have been because those games were his.
Yes.
Unfortunately, he perhaps not properly assessing his options in the crucial moments.
So in this PC, we can see that Ryoga sort of winning out the dual primals in this Premier Challenge. Although dual primals in this PC really pulling a lot of weight, actually.
I suppose. But we didn't really see the number of people who brought dual primals today.
Yeah. In fact, we don't really see a lot of big six. In my Swiss rounds, I saw a lot more dual primals than big six.
So did I. The only big six I saw was my own, which did not fare well at all. Alright, so we're moving to an interview with our Premier Challenge winner, Harrold.
Yes.
So stay tuned. Alright, I am joined with today's winner of the Premier Challenge, Harrold Khoo, who wins his first Premier Challenge ever, I believe. So congratulations, Harrold. Alright, so Harrold, I believe you can lump your team under the very common archetype that we know as Rayogre, so Kyogre, Rayquaza. But actually, the thing about your team is that you actually adapted elements of the Big Six into your team. with Kangaskhan, Smeargle, and Talonflame, which are things that you don't really see on regular teams. Would you like to tell us more about the thought process?
So it's like, I use Smeargle for mainly for follow me purposes instead of Dark Void. And then the Tailwind support with the fake out to like prevent my opponent from making a move.
Alright, so I'd like to talk a bit about game one of the finals. On turn one, I believe, you actually stayed in non-Mega Kangaskhan. I went for a fake out onto his Kangaskhan.
I was hoping for the speed tie, that I won the speed tie and then just go for a Dark Void.
Oh, I see, but the thing is that because you stay in non-Mega Inner Focus, because if you were hoping to win the speed tie, then there was no reason to stay in a non-Mega form. So
actually,
I was thinking, was that a misclick?
No, because I brought in Rayquaza, so it's like deciding whether to
Mega evolve your Kangaskhan. I see. So you were hoping for a speed tie there, but unfortunately you didn't get it.
Yes.
And your Smeargle got punished for it.
Yeah.
But again, a very bad turn one, but you clawed your way back quite well, in fact. And for most of the games, in fact, you were the one with Tailwind up. You were the one putting all the pressure onto Wilson's side of the field. So is that a very core element of the way your team functions? Tailwind, and then from there you just play your way out.
I just look at his mon before the team preview. It's like the mon of his team preview, and then it's like there's either any potential trick rule, so I just use Tailwind straight away.
So Tailwind is a big part of your team, but when you play, let's say you play outside of Tailwind, are you the type of player who likes to go for max speed primals or minimum speed primals so that you don't really have to guess speeds? What's your philosophy when it comes to playing your primals against opposing primals?
Opposing primals, I will go for the speed that's in between of max and minimum. So it's like when there's a trick room of Tailwind, it's quite balanced.
So, and again, we saw you bring Kangaskhan and Rayquaza into almost all of your games here today. Is that something that you usually do? Bring Rayquaza in its non-Mega form?
Yeah.
Or is that something that just happened to work very well against Wilson because he was bringing Dual Primal?
Normally, I would just Mega Evolve my Kangaskhan, but then it's like, after much consideration, it's like, so it's like, when there's Primals, right, so it's like, I will just use Delta Stream, so it's like, prevent the increase power of the move.
Alright, so congratulations once again, Harrold. And I believe Harrold will be winning this Sableye Pikachu for his troubles.
Thank you.
So again, congratulations, Harrold, and we will see you next time at our next Premier Challenge in 2 weeks.
Thank you.
Goodbye.